Hey, what's up everybody? In the last video, I reviewed the Dragonarc Fold 3 and I promised you to compare it to the Dragonarc Fold Pro because there were so little differences in these two machines. I wanted to have a closer look at what the actual difference is. So in today's video, we're gonna have a look at both of these two machines and find out what the difference is. So let's dive down and have a look at them. So this is the Dragonarc Fold Pro. As you can see, it has a stroke adjustable system and it goes from 2.4 millimeter stroke all the way up to 4.2 millimeters. The voltage has a range from 4.0 all the way up to 12. Now, I don't really recommend to use 12 volts for your tattooing, but it has the possibility. Now you can adjust your grip like so and your stroke adjustments, and it doesn't really vibrate and it is not very noisy when you're using it. Even when you plug the cartridge in, it's still not making too much noise or too many vibrations. Now let's head over to the Dragonarc Fold 3. Basically everything is the same about this machine. The stroke is adjustable from 2.0 to 4.2 as well. Biggest difference is right here on the top where you have four buttons. One is to turn it on. Your voltage will also go from 4.0 all the way up to 12 volts, but you have the little M button which will let you toggle between your lining and your shading memory set for your voltage. Also, this machine does not make any noise at all. It is very comfortable to work with. It's not vibrating that much, and even when you plug the cartridge in, it is not really noisy at all. Now, as you can see, these two machines are both very similar to each other in size and in weight, and the stroke adjustments and everything is pretty much the same. Now, I am just eager to find out what the actual difference is. Now, I have been tattooing with both of these machines, and even with the tattooing, I don't really find a very big difference. So the only difference really is the price tag. This machine is around $179 and this one is $279, so almost $200 more expensive than the Fold 3, where the Fold 3 is actually a much newer tattoo machine and this one is a little bit older, but it's called the Pro. Maybe it's the name Pro where you're paying for. I have absolutely no clue. What I did find out when I was tattooing is that this machine is a little bit softer than the Pro. The Pro hits a little bit harder, but this is not necessarily a good thing, and this is what I'm gonna be explaining you a little bit when we hit the practice skin. But actually, for some reason, I feel like the Fold 3 feels a little bit more like a high-end machine. The way things adjust are just a little bit smoother, which is kind of understandable since this one is new, and I'm pretty sure that they learned from mistakes that they made in this machine and implemented it on this one. What I also really like is I got the Fold Pro with only one battery and this one has two batteries. Also, another difference is this is a magnetic battery, which is absolutely no problem because it is very small, and this one is a screw-on battery, so you can screw it on and off like so, which I actually prefer. But that's all personal preference. The rest of the stroke adjustments are the same. This one does go a little bit smoother than on the Fold Pro. It's a little bit harder to adjust it, but it's all very minor things. Now we're actually gonna hit the practice skin and see how these machines compare to each other, which one works nicer and which one works best. So make sure you stay tuned and we're gonna hit the practice skin. Now, the needles we're going to be using today are provided by InkSafe. I came across an advert on Instagram and I saw that they send out a free sample box. I only had to pay the shipping, which was a little bit less than $10, I believe. We're going to use these needles. They come in various sizes, so that also gives us a good option to test a lot of different sizes for these two machines today and see which will actually put out the best. So if you want to use any of these needles, I will link the store in the description down below so you can have a look at them and maybe order a sample box for yourself or order some of your favorite needles over there. Now, what I'm going to be starting out with is I'm going to start with the Dragonarc Fold Pro right here. And I have four different liners set up right here on top. I've got the 3-round liner. Then I've got the 5-round liner, all regular needles. I've got the 7-round liner and a 9-round liner. Then after, we're gonna use the magnums. We're gonna use a 9 curved magnum and a 15 curved magnum. They were all in the sample box and we're all gonna be using them for this video today. But that's gonna be for later. We're gonna start off with lining. I'm gonna use only the 3.6 to start off for the smaller needles. Here you go, 3.6 for the smaller needles. And then probably when we hit that 7-round liner, we're gonna go up to 3.9. And for the 9-round liner, we're probably gonna use the 4.2 as well. So we're gonna fire it up. We're gonna start with the 3-round liner and we're just gonna pull a couple of lines and see how it feels. We're gonna use that at 8 volts. And let's see how she does. As you can hear, it's running pretty good. Need to adjust stroke a little bit. All right. So this will be the Fold Pro. Let's do a couple of lines. Here we go. You can hear it stuttering a little bit, but that's okay. It's a 3.6 millimeter stroke, so it's not the strongest stroke. All right, cool. Let's quickly hop over to the 5-round liner. Same thing, 8 volts. 3.6 millimeter stroke. Here we go. Doing really well. I'm gonna hang the needle a little bit so I don't create huge puddles on the practice skin. Well, that's pretty nice. Let's quickly head over to the 7-round liner. Here we go. That was a little bit too light. Now let's quickly actually move it to 3.9 millimeter stroke right now. See how much of a difference that makes when we use a 7-round liner. See, it does line a little bit nicer. All right. Now, let's quickly go to the 9-round liner. Here we go.
good.
Now let's actually go to that 4.2 millimeter stroke, see if that makes a difference with a 9 mag or with a 9 round liner. Practice skin, probably not that much. I do think for liners like this, the 3.9 millimeter stroke is probably a bit better. Now I do feel like it is struggling a little bit, but it could also have to do with either the needles or because it's practice skin, because I don't tattoo practice skin that often, only for videos like this. So yeah, it's always a little bit of getting used to whenever I'm tattooing on practice skin. Now we're gonna head over to the full three. We're gonna do the exact same thing. We're gonna start with the 3 round liner, go up to the 5, to the 7, and then do a 7 with a little bit of a higher stroke, the 3.9 that is, and then we're gonna go over to the 9 round liner and do basically exactly the same what I did with the Fold Pro as well. And then we're gonna head over to do the shading. So we're gonna start with the 3 round liner, and it just sounds a little bit slower, but we're gonna see if I need to increase the voltage. I will do so. Let's dip in a little bit of ink, and we're gonna head on right underneath these lines over here. Yeah, here we go. Pretty good. Ones. Ran out of ink. That's okay. Same thing, still at 3.6. See how she's gonna hold up. You can see that the Pro was actually really struggling right here. Let's see if this machine does the same. It does feel like it, but it doesn't show. Okay, let's actually click it to 3.9 and do a couple more lines with this, see if it makes a difference. Need a little bit more ink than that. Now let's go to that 9 round liner. We're gonna start with a 3.9 millimeter stroke. Mm-hmm. see that it's starting to struggle just a little bit. Let's see what happens when we put this on the 4.2. Kind of rough still. For some reason, this thing seems to operate a little bit more stable, and I just cannot put my finger on why that is. Maybe it's a personal thing, but yeah, that's what I felt. Like, this Fold 3 feels legitimately a bit more like a higher end tattoo machine, especially when you're lining, also when you're shading, but we're gonna get to that now. Now for shading, I'm only gonna use it from 2.4. Let's actually go 2.7 to 3.3 and see how that works, because usually I shade around 3.3 or 3.6, but for this video, I also wanna show a little bit like the lower end of this machine. The 2.4 I rarely use, but we are gonna do 3.0, 3.3 and 3.6. Now, of course, we're gonna start with the Fold Pro again. I'm gonna do the top, and then I'm gonna do underneath with the Fold 3. Now, first we're gonna put this into 3.3. We're gonna start at 3.3, and we're gonna start with the 9-curve Magnum. Beautiful. Okay, let's fire it up. Of course, we're gonna slow the voltage down. 6.5 volts. Adjust the grip, it's a little bit less far out there. Okay, let's dip in some ink. And Vaseline. So this is 3.3 at 6.5 volts, okay? Trying to get the best position for you guys. I'm sorry if it's not the best. So it's pretty soft to shade with this. Can build it up, which is very nice. You can see it's very soft, subtle shading. Let's go to 3.0. Now this should be even softer. Need to readjust my needle just a little bit. And here we go again. Mm-hmm.
you can see, here's where it starts to get really smooth. It might be hard to see on the camera, but the dots are just getting a little bit more smoky instead of being an actual dot, which is what you want in your shading, right? Let's go to 2.7. Now it does start to run a little bit quicker when you do that because it changes the frequency of the machine a little bit. So I might have to slow it down on the voltage, but we'll see what happens. Here we go. I can see I'm kind of creating a bit of lines. It does come out pretty soft. But I don't know if you can see it on the camera. If you start creating, like if you see like little lines while you're whip shading, you might want to turn that voltage down a little bit. So now I'm at 6.0. Now I just got rid of those lines when I'm shading because you just want to see dots, or at least that's what I always like to. There. Now, of course, we're gonna do the same thing, but then with the 15 Magnum. Now it does take a little bit more effort to get this needle in, which is very usual to happen. And you can also see it's a bigger needle. It just creates a little bit of a nicer and smoother shade as well. Now we're gonna go to 3.0, still 6.5 volts, and let's do the same thing. You can see it's just a little bit lighter than the one before, just because this is just getting a bit softer when you put the stroke length down. We're gonna go to 2.7, see if I have to go down in voltage as well. Good. Yeah, it's really soft. Quickly clean that.
And you can see Fold Pro does create really nice soft shading, and it does work really nice. Now we're gonna see what the difference is with the Fold 3. See if anything is different on this machine. We are gonna go to 3.3 and we're gonna start with the 9 Magnum. Now I am not using any diluted ink. This is all just pure black from an ink bottle I got in a kit one day that I just used for practice skin basically. So we're gonna fire the machine up. We're gonna go to 6.5 volts. Let's create some shading. Now let's have a look. Gonna put it right underneath. Now, and this is kind of what I meant. This machine is a bit softer. It creates super nice shading. I don't know what they changed in this. Maybe something is different in the motor, even though it says it is the same. We're gonna go to 3.0 millimeter stroke now and see if it just continues to get softer. Here we go. It's softer, it creates a nice smoother shade faster. I just don't know why that is. Let's go to 2.7. Still sounds like the frequency remains the same. Let's go do a bit of shading. I do notice a little bit of a difference in sound now on the practice skin. You can see it as well. It is a little bit denser of a shade when you, or it's a bit more saturated at the lower stroke. Now let's do the same thing, but then with the 15 curved Magnum. There you go. This is really nice shading. Now it is, you can see it is a bit softer, or this one is a little bit darker. Now it could be because I maybe passed over this a couple more times, but I definitely like the way this one shades. I'm gonna go to 3.0. This is really soft. Perfect. Alright, now let's go to 2.7. This is just another very smooth shade. So let's wipe everything down and see if we can spot any differences in the way that they are tattooing. Okay, so everything that's at the top, just to quickly summarize, everything that's on the top is going to be done with the Fold Pro, and everything that's on the bottom is what is going to be done with the Fold 3. So let's quickly go over the lining. I don't know if you can see, but these lines look very wobbly, and I can feel like when I'm putting pressure onto the practice skin that it starts to kind of bounce around a little bit. I don't know if that's because it's hitting really hard and it tries to push the needle deeper into the practice skin where it cannot really push it anymore. I really don't know. When I did the same thing with the Fold 3, I can tell, like, this is the 7-round liner on the 3.6 millimeter stroke. It starts to do the same thing, but definitely not as bad as it is here. Like, you can definitely tell at a lower, the Fold Pro at a lower stroke is really struggling to put in these lines, where with the Fold 3, it actually goes a lot smoother. Now here with the 9, you can see it. That actually worked a little bit better on the Fold Pro because it goes in a little bit smoother. This was at the 3.9 millimeter stroke, but then with the 4.2 millimeter stroke, I think it was pushing a little bit too hard again, where you can see here it was actually struggling a little bit with the 3.9 millimeter stroke, and then with the 4.2 it actually went a lot better. Now for the shading as well, you can see that definitely the Fold 3 pushes out a lot smoother shading. Now, we haven't really tried color packing. I will see if we can maybe do a video packing color with these two. But you can see that the Fold Pro actually hits a lot harder, which is not really benefiting actually with the operation of the machine. You can see that the shading on the Fold 3 is a lot smoother than it is on the Fold Pro. So yeah, this was definitely cool to test out. Now let's quickly go back up top and let's talk about these machines just a little bit more. Now, I hope you really enjoyed watching this video, and I hope I didn't make it too long for you guys. Well, if you stick all the way to the end, let me know in the comments which one of these machines you think is the better one. In my opinion, the Fold 3 is a lot better. They have changed a couple of things on the machine that just feels like this machine is working so much better. And a big plus is also that mode button where you can switch in between your lining and shading memory settings. That just makes everything so much easier when you're tattooing. Also, that everything is on the top is also a big pro, and the way it adjusts, I'm just super excited about this machine, and it's really nice to work with. Now, I don't say that the Fold Pro is a bad machine. I actually love working with that machine as well, but when you compare both of them to each other, you can just see that in the Fold 3 they have learned a lot from the past things that they did in the other Fold machines and in the Fold Pro machine, and you can definitely tell the difference. Now, of course, I don't know, since the Fold 3 is $100 cheaper than the Fold Pro, I don't know if it's gonna last shorter or longer or stuff like that. I really don't know. That's what I have to find out for myself as well. All I know is when I take it to the practice skin for you guys today that the Fold 3 just operates a lot better in my perspective. And I also felt that way when I was tattooing on skin, because this Friday I will also show you a video where I'm actually using the Fold 3. It's going to be probably a lining video, and then in the next week I'm going to do a shading video about the Fold 3 as well, so you can also see how it operates on the skin. So if you don't want to miss that out, make sure you do subscribe to the channel. And yeah, let me know, like this video, let me know in the comments which of these two machines you think is better judged on this video, or maybe judged on your experience, because maybe you have both of these machines. Now, I hope I informed you well. If you are looking to buy any of these machines, I will put the link in the description down below, and the same will go for the InkSafe needles that we have been using today, because they have actually done a really good job today in doing this video. So that was really nice to actually test these needles and test these two machines at the same time. Now, I hope you enjoyed and have a wonderful day, and then I will see you guys Friday in the next video.